Hi students, today we are starting our new chapter, respiration in plants. All living things use a process called respiration to get energy to stay alive. Cellular respiration in plant is a process used by plants to convert glucose made during photosynthesis into energy which fuels the plant cellular activities. On the other hand, photosynthesis is a process where light energy is converted into chemical energy is stored in glucose that can later be used in respiration. Photosynthesis occurs on green plants that contain chlorophyll. During respiration, plants consume food to keep plant cells alive. During photosynthesis, plants create their own food. Respiration is one of the important chemical process which is carried out by all living organisms, including plants, animals and humans, in order to release energy required for life process. The process of respiration occurs both during the presence or in absence of oxygen. For instance, human beings undergo the process of respiration by inhaling oxygen gas and exhaling carbon dioxide gas. Many other living organisms, including plant and animals, undergo respiration process to obtain energy for their metabolic activities. Respiration is of two types, aerobic and anaerobic. Anaerobic, it is a type of respiration where oxygen is not utilized. Now glycolysis. All living organisms retain the enzymatic machinery to partially oxidize glucose without the help of oxygen. This breakdown of glucose to pyruvic acid is called glycolysis. Now here we will see what is glycolysis. Glucose convert into pyruvic acid, as we know. Now see how it runs. Glucose converts to glucose 6-phosphate, fructose 6-phosphate, fructose 1,6 biphosphate. Then here it is bifurcated, dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate converts to 1,3 biphosphoglycerate isomerization. And 1,3-biphosphoglycerate converts to 3-phosphoglycerate, then 2-phosphoglycerate, then phosphoenol pyruvate, then pyruvate. And pyruvate releases carbon dioxide if it is aerobic metabolism, and if it is anaerobic metabolism, lactate is released. Now we will see glucose converts to glucose 6-phosphate in the presence of hexokinase enzyme. ATP converts to ADP. Here glucose is locked. Glucose 6-phosphate convert to fructose 6-phosphate isomerization in the presence of phosphoglucoisomerase. Now fructose 6-phosphate converts into fructose 1,6-biphosphate in the presence of phosphofructokinase. ATP converts to ADP. Here P is added. P means phosphate. Now fructose 1,6-biphosphate is bifurcated. It is converting into the dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. In the presence of aldolase enzyme, cleavage takes place. Now glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate converts into 1,3-biphosphoglycerate in the presence of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme, and NAD is converting into NADH plus hydrogen ion. 1,3-biphosphoglycerate converts to 3-phosphoglycerate in the presence of phosphoglycerokinase. ADP converts to ATP, and it is first ATP to glycolysis. 3-phosphoglycerate converts to 2-phosphoglycerate in the presence of phosphoglyceromutase. 2-phosphoglycerate converts to phosphoenol pyruvate in the presence of enolase enzyme activation of phosphate molecule. Phosphoenol pyruvate convert to pyruvate. ADP converts to ATP, and it releases carbon dioxide, which is aerobic respiration, in the presence of pyruvate kinase, and it releases lactate if it is anaerobic metabolism. Now see here, this NAD converts to NADH by addition of H ion. In the presence of dehydrogenase enzyme, hydrogen is released. As you can see, by the name dehydrogenase. D means removal of hydrogen, this is NAD, and it converts again to NAD ion, which is added with the phosphate, and again it forms the NADH. Now we'll see, a phosphate group is added to glucose in the cell cytoplasm by the action of enzyme hexokinase. In this, a phosphate group is transferred from ATP to glucose, forming glucose 6-phosphate. Glucose 6-phosphate is isomerized into fructose 6-phosphate in the presence of enzyme phosphoglucomutase. The other ATP molecule transfers a phosphate group to fructose 6-phosphate and converts it into fructose 1,6-biphosphate by the action of enzyme phosphofructokinase. The enzyme aldolase converts fructose 1,6-biphosphate into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate, which are isomers of each other. Triose phosphate isomerase converts dihydroxyacetone phosphate into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, which is the substrate in the successive step of glycolysis. This step undergoes two reaction. The enzyme glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase transferred one hydrogen molecule from glyceraldehyde phosphate to nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, means NAD, to form NADH plus H. Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase adds a phosphate to oxidize glyceraldehyde phosphate to form 1,3-biphosphoglycerate. Phosphate is transferred from 1,3-biphosphoglycerate to ADP to form ATP with the help of the phosphoglycerokinase. Thus, two molecules of phosphoglycerate and ATP are obtained at the end of this reaction. The phosphate of both the phosphoglycerate molecule is relocated from 3rd to 2nd carbon to yield two molecules of phosphoglycerate by the enzyme phosphoglycerolmutase. The enzyme enolase removes a water molecule from 2-phosphoglycerate to form phosphoenol pyruvate. A phosphate from phosphoenol pyruvate is transferred to ADP to form pyruvate and ATP by the action of pyruvate kinase. Two molecules of pyruvate and ATP are obtained as the end product. Now, key points of glycolysis. It is the process in which a glucose molecule is broken down into two molecules of pyruvate. The process takes place in the cytoplasm of plant and animal of the cell. 6 enzymes are involved. The two end products of reaction include 2-pyruvate, 2-ATP and 2-NADH molecule. Today, whatever I have taught you, I am sending you its PDF. Thank you.